Today we're going to look at integrating machine learning using CoreML with FileMaker. The first step is to either download an existing CoreML model, or we can create our own using a tool called CreateML. With this demo, we're going to go through and actually create our own using CreateML. So first thing we need to do is open Xcode, and then go to the Xcode menu, and then open Developer Tool, and that's where you'll find the CreateML tool. Then I'm just going to make a new document on my desktop. Here we can choose which type of model we can create. So we're going to be doing image classifier, but there are other options for sounds, activities, texts, and also data. But for now, let's just choose image classifier. And then I'll leave the defaults in there. And then create. So here we have the graphical interface for creating the model. There's no code involved, so it's very easy. All we really need to do is create a data set or use an existing one. So what I've done is downloaded the Caltech 101 data set, which is a collection of images used for machine learning purposes. You can download it for yourself from their website. So I just have it here on my desktop. If we open up this folder, you'll see that there are lots of different subfolders for different types of objects. So if I open one of these, say dragonfly, we just have a ton of different images of dragonflies. So using this type of structure, where we have one main folder with different subfolders with the name of the object we want to identify, all we have to do is drag that in to CreateML. So I'm just going to hit choose here from the training data and select that folder. It is quite a bit of data, so it's going to take a second. And then all we have to do is hit train. And this will run through and basically create our model. It's just that easy. Once this is done, we'll have an output of a CoreML file that we can actually just import into FileMaker. So once this is done, we'll look at that. Okay, we now have our model created, and you can see the output here. So I'm just going to go ahead and drag that to my desktop. And then let's hop back over to FileMaker. So you can see I already have the model in here, but I'm just going to delete it. And then just drag this in. It's very easy. All you'll need is a container field to hold your model, and then another container field to hold the image that you want to run through the model to test. Okay, let's look at the scripts now. There's a couple of machine learning script steps that we'll be using. The first is configure machine learning model. The first parameter is specifying that it's a vision model, which just means we'll be working with images. And then we give it a name so that we can reference the model later on. And then we're going to load in from this container field. So this container field is the one here that's holding the model. And then we're just going to set a result variable to running our image through the model. So let me open this up. The first parameter here is the name that we gave our model earlier, just so that we could reference it. Image, the string of image, is just specifying that we're going to be using an image model. And then this is our container that holds our test image. And these last two parameters here are actually optional, confidence lower limit and return at least one. With confidence lower limit, that's specifying the confidence level that you want to return. So right now it's set at 1, but let's say I set it to 0.5. That would only give me results where it was 50% confident that it was the image. What it classified the image as is correct. With it set to 1, that's basically going to exclude everything since the max confidence is 1. So with return at least 1, these are to be used together. So if you exclude everything but want to return at least 1, that's going to give you back the first result no matter what. So what you do get back is quite a large array of different classifications. So let's say I was trying to identify this helicopter. It could come back with 100% helicopter and then have 99 other possibilities that it could think it was, but with a lower confidence level. And then the last thing is very important. It's, again, we're going to use configure machine learning model, but this time we're going to unload the model and then reference it with the name we gave earlier. So what this is doing is unloading all the resources and memory for computing the model. So we want to make sure we do this right after we compute our results, just so that we we don't leave any memory hung up with the resources that it needs to compute the model. And then all I'm doing here is just setting some variables so that we can parse out the classification and the confidence so that we can display it on the screen. So let's go ahead and take a look at what this does. So right now we have a helicopter in here. So I'm going to classify test image, which is going to run the script. So you can see it says it's a helicopter and it's 100% confident. And then I just have some other test images here. It says it's kangaroo, it's 100% confident. So it's pretty good at what it's doing. And then let me open up just some random image from the data set. So let's try dolphin. And if I drag one of these in here, it should be able to correctly identify the dolphin, let's hope. Oh, yep. Yeah. It's not quite 100% confident, but it got it. As you can see, incorporating machine learning into your FileMaker system is pretty easy and offers a range of possibilities from image classification to predictive data analysis. So if you need assistance setting up machine learning using CoreML and FileMaker, contact DB Services and we'll be happy to help.